An ordinary man, insurance executive, 45 years old, stumbles to his death on a subway platform in New York City. Or does he? Unbeknownst to his wife or child, his brain is rescued from the accident scene by a secret branch of the United States government and put into the body of an artificially produced 26-year-old man who has the strength of Superman, the speed of Michael Jordan, and the grace of Fred Astaire. The only catch, under penalty of death, he can never let anyone from his past know he is still alive. And that, my friends, is the problem. For this man is desperately in love with his wife, his daughter, and his former life.
Before, on Now and Again.
I want you to hear me, Mr. Newman. I want you to hear me loud and clear. I know who you are. I know where you live. I have witnesses now. The girl in the flower shop, the bank manager, they can identify you.
From this moment forward, Mr. Wiseman, until such time as I receive word that our funding for next year is in place, you will not leave this townhouse under any circumstances.
Okay.
I want you out of my life, Mr. Newman. I want you out of my head.
And not only that, I, or someone under my command, will be with you every minute of every day. Are you clear?
Absolutely, I'm clear. I'm totally clear.
Good.
He's not gonna drink that, you know.
He might. You don't sell him off the idea first.
Does it have active cultures in it? He once told me he doesn't trust anything with active cultures in it.
Thank you. I think it might have a little too much yogurt. Honey! Breakfast!
Something is amiss. I don't smell bacon. Now, isn't there a law in the state of New York where it can't be called breakfast unless there's bacon or sausage or some sort of fried meat? What is that sludge? Is that a crafts project? Are you grouting the sink, darling?
It's very funny. Go ahead, make fun. Go ahead.
Well, okay, but only because you insist. Did you make these? I mean, they look excellent.
So that was all just a big act. That speech you made about watching what you eat.
No, honey, it wasn't an act, but couldn't I watch myself eat a couple of fried eggs and two strips of bacon? Oh, by the way, I'm taking my car to work today, and I won't be home for dinner. I have to drive to Somerset and wine and dine some VP of finance. You're not talking to me? I kind of like it.
Ha, ha, ha. You know, all that money that we spent on that timeshare in Florida, I'd just like to have someone around to share it with. Is that so crazy?
Yeah, it's totally crazy. What are you talking about? What is she talking about? Honey, I'm going to be around for a while, right? You're stuck with me for life.
You think so, huh?
I know so.
Know it again. Try to remember who I am.
We only want what we can't have. What we can't have, yeah.
Know it again. Try to remember all you can.
We only want what we can't have. What we can't have, you do.
We never see what's good until it's left behind.
We only want what we can't have. What we can't have.
Hey, Raj, it's Michael. Yeah, the dinner went great. I had him eating out of the palm of my hand. Speaking of double, just pulled up behind me. Yeah, I'll give you the gruesome details tomorrow.
Like a light. Must be the complete lack of stimulation.
Something about never being allowed to leave this place. Never being alone. At the end of the day, my head hits the pillow and all I want to do is die. Oh, wait. I already did that. You see that? All work and no play makes Michael a very dull boy.
Yeah, I can't sleep either. I guess I'm nervous about tomorrow, too.
Well, calm down. Nothing's gonna go wrong. Couldn't possibly practice any more than we've practiced.
It's not you I'm worried about. It's the politics of it all. In 30 days, this project runs out of funding. And believe it or not, there are those at the Pentagon who would gladly let us die. One little slip-up tomorrow. One little gaffe.
Hey, Doc, are you forgetting? I've got a lot more to lose if they stop bankrolling this shindig than you do. I mean, yeah, you've got to find another impossible scientific challenge like making dogs talk or curing the common cold, but hey, at the end of the day, if they clean out the lab and send everybody home, I'll actually be in that giant hefty bag they leave by the curb.
You're right, Mr. Wiseman. We just have to have a positive attitude. I just have to have a positive attitude. Tomorrow, you're going to demonstrate your powers for General Irving, the chairman of the Pentagon Committee that funds us.
And it'll be a snap.
And 2 days later, our budget will be approved.
I'll beat up some bad guys, lift some heavy stuff, just like we practiced.
Then it'll be back to business as usual.
Absolutely. You'll see. Faster than you can say government pork barrel, we'll be up to our eyeballs in fruits and veggies again. My stomach's growling just thinking about it. Hey, maybe they'll even give us a new bulb for that damn light in there. What do you think, Doc?
Well, obviously, you've never dealt with a federally funded agency before. Towards the end of a budget year, routine maintenance tends to be put on hold. Thank you, Mr. Wiseman. I don't know what came over me. I feel better now. Let's try to get some sleep. We're going to need it for that demonstration tomorrow.
You're right. Scientist works from sun to sun, but his lab rat's work is never done.
Where am I?
You're in a hospital, Mr. Wiseman, in Somerset, New Jersey.
What happened?
Well, we're not sure. You were unconscious in your car.
What are you telling me? I passed out?
Seems that way. I'm guessing for about 45 minutes or so. The problem is, we can't seem to determine a cause. I mean, frankly, from everything we've been able to determine, you seem perfectly fine.
Well, that's good, isn't it?
Well, it's good you came out of it. But as a general rule, people don't just lose consciousness without cause. It usually suggests that there's something else going on. A problem with the heart, problem with the brain.
Well, good, as long as it's nothing major.
Well, I'd like to hold on to you for about another hour or so, just to be sure that you're fine. And then I'll let you go. But there are a series of tests that ought to be performed. Now, you can come back here and have them done, or I can contact your personal physician and he can do them.
Well, that depends. Does anybody know I'm here? Have you called anyone?
I didn't know. But the police might have when they brought you in. Why?
I don't want to panic anyone. I mean, I'd rather come back here.
That's fine. That's fine. All right, now I want you to take it easy for the next couple of days. No exertion, no exercise, eat lightly, no sex. And come back here and see me Friday at 3 and we'll run you through these tests. You want an appointment card?
No, I got it.
Okay.
Shoot.
Dr. Francis, 3 p.m. Friday.
Go.
Oh, man, please. Give me a heart attack.
Should I put the light on first?
It went fine. It went fine.
Well, it sure went late. What time is it?
Almost 1 o'clock.
Wow. What did you do?
You know.
Uh-huh. Oh. You missed sophomore parents' night. Sophomore parents' night. You lucky devil. Heather and I met up with her ninth grade English teacher. And we shut the place down. Missed you. What? Something I said? What?
Well, you know, I gotta get up in 5.5 hours.
Right. Great. Let it be said I kept you from a good night's sleep.
Oh, come on, listen. Don't do this. Just give me a couple minutes. I'll come back in there. We can cuddle or something.
Cuddle? I'm offering you the full American plan, and you want to cuddle. What's wrong, Michael?
What's wrong? I'm under a lot of pressure at work.
Mr. Wiseman? Goodness. All the mornings to oversleep. Mr. Wiseman? Mr. Wiseman, I think I may have left my watch in there. Mr. Wiseman, I need my watch. Mr. Wiseman, it's 20 after and I still need to get in there. Mr. Wiseman.
What do you make of the latest data, sir?
I don't know. Worst case scenario is the host body rejecting the brain. Mr. Wiseman. This is Dr. Morris. I'm going to try something that may help you get better. The only thing is, it may also hurt. I'm sorry. The paddles. Give me 75 joules.
Already brain dead.
Now you listen to me. as a person there. And I'm not sure, but I'm betting and hoping that person can hear us. And the last thing he needs right now, the very last thing he needs, is to hear you give up on him. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
And this is where we actually house and train the Mr. Wiseman.
Right in the middle of Manhattan, huh? Sort of a hide-in-plain-sight philosophy.
That and the proximity to the UN and Washington.
You must be very proud. I hear he's quite something.
I must tell you, every day I'm more amazed than the last. Every day I'm more excited than the day before.
You sound like a proud new father. So now, where is he? Where's our boy? Dr. Morris? My God.
You have to understand that this condition's only 4 or 5 hours old. We've really just begun the diagnostic process.
Well, if I were you, I would hurry it along. I'm supposed to brief the president about this in the next 24 hours.
Anyway, I thought I'd have legal come into my office. We'd hash out a way to separate underwriting the bridge from all the other construction projects, and that way we'd be able to... Hey, Michael. You okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what do you think?
Huh? Oh, it's good. It's real good.
Okay, so, should we meet with legal?
Now? I can't do it now. I gotta go. I gotta step out for a while.
Wait, in the middle of the day? What for?
I gotta go meet Lisa about this thing we're doing.
Oh, well.
You know. No big deal. I'll catch you later, buddy.
Yeah. Yeah, good luck with that thing.
So how have you been feeling, Mr. Wiseman? Any more episodes?
Well, not that I'm aware of. Of course, I wasn't aware of the first one until it was over.
You ready for some tests?
I want to run every test known to medical science.
So, Mr. Wiseman, I'll need the name of your personal physician so I can have a look at your medical records.
I want you to find Mr. Wiseman's physician. Maybe his medical records can tell us something.
I'd rather not, if you don't mind. My wife lost her brother and her father to heart attacks at a young age. And our family physician is a friend of ours, so if he finds out, she'll find out. I'd rather not upset her. I can get you the records from the insurance company, okay?
All right. Well, hopefully I'll find what I need there. Now try and relax, Mr. Wiseman. We're going to make you as comfortable as we can.
Okay, Mom. Ready? Look at Daddy's little genius. Smile. Okay.
That's right.
Come on,
she's got a good this. What?
Sit down. Good, sit down. Come on, let's play.
Michael, you have 35 tapes of us doing this.
We'll be good. We'll get 36. We'll get it right. Come on.
Yes.
Yeah, we can try. I feel a song coming on.
Hello?
Roger. It's Lisa.
Hey, Lisa. What's up?
I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm looking for Michael. And nobody seems to know where he is. He's not in your office, is he?
No. No, he isn't. He left about 2 o'clock. I thought he was going somewhere to meet you.
You did? Did he say that to you?
I can't remember if he actually said it or if I imagined it.
Let me look around, see if he's here. I'll have him give you a call.
Thanks, Roger. I'd appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yes.
We located Michael Weissman's family physician. Nothing unusual in his records.
Nothing at all.
Thank you for flying in this morning, Doctor. I believe I have some good news for you.
Good news? Well, good news is always worth flying in for, sir.
Please. You look tired.
Any progress on the diagnostics?
I can't lie to you, General. There have been no changes. I'm begging you, sir. This project is far too important to mothball.
Well, there's no need to beg, Doctor. I agree with you. So does the President. We have no intention of shutting you down. We believe in this project. Well, we believe in you.
Well, thank you, sir. And please let the President know that I appreciate his confidence as well.
Well, he already knows that. In fact, he wanted me to make it a priority that you continue your work in the most expeditious way possible. So, what's our next move?
Our next move? Well, clearly, we need to continue our diagnostic panels. And I know this must seem endless, but every time we can eliminate a possible systemic basis, we actually narrow the locus of the actual probable cause.
Come now, Doctor. I think the probable cause is fairly obvious. Well, for that matter, the most expedient and cost-effective solution is fairly obvious as well.
I'm sorry.
Clearly, Doctor, we need a new brain.
I know that smell.
I'm just trying to comply with state law. Ooh. And I know what kind of pressure you're under at work.
I'd go for it, Daddy, before she whips out the blender.
Maybe I'll just have some coffee.
I was thinking of driving into the city today and meeting you for lunch. What do you think of that?
Today?
Yeah.
Oh, God, I'd love that, but I can't make it work today.
No? No. Well, what about yesterday? Would it have worked if I came in yesterday? Would you excuse us, please? I have to talk to your father.
It's okay. I'm not 10, you know.
Do you want to live to be 20?
What are you talking about yesterday? And why are you so upset because I can't arrange my schedule at the drop of a hat to have lunch with you?
Who's Francis at 3 p.m.? Who is this?
Nobody.
Nobody? Well, If she's nobody, why weren't you in your office when I called yesterday at 3 p.m.?
First of all, it's not a she. Second of all, you're going to have to trust me.
Well, I do trust you. I trusted you when you were 2.5 hours late from dinner. I trusted you when you said, you know, thanks to sleeping with me. And I trusted you when I found this note.
Well, then what's the problem?
No, you're right. There's no problem.
Good. I gotta go.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for working through this with me.
Well, we'll close the door. I'm a pretty honest guy, right?
Yeah. Perhaps a little too honest for your own good. Why?
I need you to help me with something that's maybe slightly dishonest.
Oh, well, I'm flattered that you think so little of me. What can I help you with?
I want to buy another $500,000 worth of life insurance, but I'd like to duck the medical. You know, the physical exam and stuff. I'd sign it myself, but I'd set off all sorts of alarms, and I need you to walk it through for me. What do you say?
You want to tell me what this is about?
No.
Okay. Want to buy me a drink? And, they don't know what it is?
Not yet.
Can I give you some advice?
Sure.
Tell Lisa. She called the office the other day, and I can hear it in her voice. She knows something's up. She doesn't know exactly what it is.
Yeah, I know. She really let me have it at breakfast this morning. The thing is, her father and her brother both died.
Oh, yeah, right.
And I don't know. Until I'm sure what it is, I think I'd just sort of let it go. I don't know. There's always another thing.
What do you mean?
It's like I remember when I was a kid. I always get myself in some nutty situation, like going down a hill, my brother's wagon backwards, thinking, Lord, don't take me now. I haven't even kissed a girl yet. When I was in college, one night I was blind drunk. I mean, I was so drunk I was afraid of forgetting how to breathe. And I realized I'm laying out in front of my dorm in the snow without any clothes on, and I can't move. I'm probably gonna die. And I'm thinking, Lord, don't take me now. I haven't accomplished a damn thing yet. Sorry.
It's okay.
When Lisa was giving birth, I was driving to the hospital. Just feeling so responsible. I'm thinking, Lord, I really want this child. Just get us to the hospital in one piece. Don't let me hit anything. Don't let anything hit us. I'll never bother you again. Never ask you for another thing. But there's always another thing, isn't there?
Sir, after the brain is removed, I have special orders to convey it directly to Langley. The president wants an independent team to do the pathology.
Is the replacement brain here yet?
It's in OR. 27-year-old Boston cop, killed in the line of duty.
Right.
Shall I shave his head and prep him now?
No. I'd like to do that. Give me a chance to say goodbye.
This is very odd. I can't find Dr. Morris anywhere.
Keep your seatbelt buckled, Mr. Wiseman. I have a feeling we're in for a bumpy ride.
What are we doing to find my very expensive mannequin?
We've got teams searching 500 miles in every direction.
Well, I'm confused. I was under the impression there was some sort of a tracking device in its head. Why can't we get a read from that?
Yes, sir, normally we could. But apparently Dr. Morris is jamming it somehow. We'll get a signal, but it doesn't stay around long enough for us to triangulate. We are working our way around that problem.
What would make a brilliant doctor throw away everything like this? Well, I don't understand that. Do you think perhaps he's taken the prototype to a foreign agent?
General, I've known the doctor for years. He's a patriot.
His work, it's all documented. I mean, if need be, someone with the proper education and training could theoretically pick up where he left off. Good. And let the search team know they can proceed with extreme prejudice.
Mr. Wiseman? Mr. Wiseman? Hello, Mr. Wiseman. How have you been feeling?
Fine.
Good. Well, I'd like to do one last test. Are you up for it?
Sure. As long as I don't have to put that gown on again.
All right, now lay back. Now, Mr. Wiseman, we're going to flash some lights in your eyes.
Lights?
Yes. So try and relax and look directly into them.
Photo what?
Photosensitivity syndrome. Do you remember hearing about those kids in Japan a few months back? How thousands of them got sick from watching a cartoon that featured a kind of flashing light? That's photosensitivity syndrome. See, some people just react to flashing light of a certain frequency. It sets off something in the brain. You're one of those people.
That's what caused me to black out?
Without a doubt. The pathology takes different forms. I mean, one time you could black out, another time you go into a catatonic-like state where you appear to be awake. Sometimes the same flickering lights that put you into the state can actually jolt you back out.
Well, so what do? Walk around with my eyes closed for the rest of my life?
A simple prescription takes care of the whole thing.
There's nothing else wrong with me? No heart attack, no stroke, no brain tumor?
Well, you weigh too damn much. But that's completely curable, too.
Thanks.
Sure.
Thank you very much.
Sure. Oh, and Mr. Wiseman, I noticed that your cholesterol was a little high. So in addition to everything else, you might want to cut out the bacon and eggs in the morning.
No problem. My wife makes a delicious breakfast drink. Thank you.
Okay. I keep thinking you can hear me. They're coming, you know. The microwave signals in my cell phone will only jam the homing device for so long. They'll find us. Then they'll kill us. And the worst part about that, I'll never know. Is it something in you or something I did? Wouldn't it be funny, Mr. Wiseman, if you knew? If you knew and you couldn't tell me. They're gone, for now. But we should move soon. Make it interesting, at least. Where do you want to go, Mr. Wiseman? Most of us poor, pathetic souls only have to die once. Since you have to go through it a second time, you get to choose. Where do you want to die? You want to go home. Care less. I am truly a fool. Well, you know, maybe coming here is not about you at all. Mr. Wiseman, I need to leave you here for a moment. I don't know how long we have, but it occurs to me, if I don't tell your wife who you are and what you've become, she'll never know. And she ought to know, don't you think?
Yourself and the government property that you have stolen to me and these marshals immediately.
Mrs. Wiseman, please, Mrs. Wiseman, can you hear me?
Go away. I don't want to hear anything you have to say.
But Mrs. Wiseman.
Go. Go. Go.
Please, Mrs. Wiseman.
Don't you understand? I don't want to see you, and I certainly don't want to see him.
Him?
Tell her it's okay. Not to be scared. Tell her we're going to go.
Welcome back.
Oh, yeah. We gotta stop by a drugstore on the way back, pick up a prescription. I'll explain later.
They're going now, Mom. Are you okay?
I miss you, Daddy.
going to play the piano.
Lisa? Honey?
Are you looking for me?
Yeah, come on and do this with me.
No, I have things to do.
Oh, come on. It's not going to kill you to sit down for a minute. Come on. Do this with me. You start.
What's this?
My prescription from Dr. Francis.
Francis, huh?
Yep.
What's wrong with you?
He said it was nothing, it's no big deal. But I was really scared. And I'm really sorry.
It's no big deal?
No big deal. You did say I could stand to lose a few pounds.
You want a second opinion on that?
You know, it's that kind of smart remark that's going to break up the band.
Oh,